Welcome to MCN. Behind me, we've got two Honda Africa Twins. We've got the manual version, we've got the DCT version, which is the automatic transmission. The idea of today is to ride both bikes in an off-road environment, work out which one's best. Initially, with the manual bike, it does feel more confidence inspiring. You're more familiar. The difficult conditions, you need that kind of last bit of finesse with clutch and throttle control, which just inspires that extra bit of confidence and gives you the confidence again to climb things, make turns, and just feel a bit more comfortable on the bike. When you first jump on the DCT, that initial throttle connection feels a little bit vague. Just that slight delay from when you twist the throttle to something happening at the back. But the more you ride it, the more comfortable you become. And riding the bike back to back on exactly the same route, I'd say I probably felt slightly more comfortable on the manual, but there was nothing that I couldn't do on the manual that I couldn't do on the DCT bike. What the DCT does have in its favour is that you can't stall it. So whatever's going on, you never have to worry about that, chugging to a halt on a turn and maybe dropping the bike. It won't stall. And that's great. It's also got some very clever electronics, which are basically is it a gravel button, which will determine what gradient you're on and grip conditions, and will act accordingly with reference to gear changes, how long it will hold on to a gear, when it will change down a gear, and what engine levels of engine braking it will give you. So there's a lot, it does a lot for you. Rather than the manual bike, you're kind of having to do it all yourself. I think in different circumstances, if it had been dry, if you'd have been on faster flowing fire tracks with maybe an odd bit of single track, essentially more grip, I think the DCT bike would have run the manual bike very, very close. I think it would have been, negligible difference, to be perfectly honest. So kind of in summary, they are, it's a very good off-road bike. I was on the launch in South Africa of this bike, and that was my overwhelming feeling of it, that it delivers great balance, great throttle connection, it's not got too much power that upsets the chassis, it's a very, very usable bike and confidence-inspiring bike. I think in these conditions, it's been a hard test for it, as I've said. I think the manual for me is probably still my preferred choice, but I think possibly a rider that is maybe newer to off-road or with slightly less experience, I think the DCT is quite possibly the way to go because of the confidence it inspires and the fact that it just takes a lot of things out of the equation. So really, you've got to go and try these motorbikes. You need to back to back them. That is my overwhelming message, because if you haven't experienced DCT, I think the general feeling is that it can't be any good. It can't be better than me as a rider. But genuinely, the guys in Japan in Honda don't mess about, and they have done an amazing job. DCT is not a new thing on motorcycles. They've been running the DCT for 5-6 years now, and it constantly evolves. And the latest version on the Africa Twin is another level again, with off-road specific DCT. So, both great motorbikes. It's down to you. You need to go and try them and experience it firsthand, then make a decision.